and welcome to the show. I am here today taking a look at Ride 4. Yes, I am in unusual surroundings as I try to figure out how not to crash a bike. Now, whenever I do a video on a game that involves bikes, I will always make this disclaimer, shall we say. I know basically nothing about bikes at all. I like them, they're interesting, they're fast, quite cheap for the performance you get, but I know bugger all about them. I know the Hayabusa was very quick top speed. Is it the H2G or something like that? Is a crazy wacky Kawasaki thing that has a weird little spoiler. Actually, do we have that on this game? Let's go have a look. Let's go have a look in the dealership. I think it was a Kawasaki. Do we have the wacky thing with the sticky outy like spoiler, front spoiler? I think I know what I'm talking about. Oh, H2R, there we go, not G. Ignore me. Oh, it is here, there we go. This thing with a little like kind of wings on the front. It's crazy. I love it. Very, very quick. I mean, 310 horsepower in a 200 kilo bike is insane. Yeah, it goes full on raceway. There's lots of bikes in here. I don't really know much about, as I said, I don't know much about bikes. I don't really know how to ride bikes particularly well, but I do enjoy this game. I do enjoy Ride. I mean, Ride is essentially the Forza or Gran Turismo of bike games, which is cool. This is the fourth iteration. I've enjoyed all the previous ones I've played, and this one, there's just a bit more to it. There's a bit more going on. A couple of annoying things about it, which we'll get to later. Let's just go jump into the career mode. So, if you want a game that has a lot of single-player stuff to do, you will be set. So, you start off on these kind of continent leagues, if you like. I've just started on the Euro one here. We've worked our way through some of it. We've got an Asian league. So, this will all be but the circuits will all be from that kind of area. You then go on to the World League that has got so much to do. You've got all of this stuff. You've got superbikes. You've got endurance racing, which I probably will never do. I'm not a massive fan of endurance racing. You've got invitational events going on. You've got exhibition events going on, and you've got some activities as well. There is so much to do. I've barely scratched the surface of this game, having played it for 4 or 5 hours so far. Now, some of these, for example, here, we go do this race. You win all three of these rounds, or all of these five rounds, sorry, and you will win a free bike. So there's quite a few reward bikes around the place for you to be getting. You don't just have to buy bikes with the currency. Right, let's go. I was working on, actually, you know what, let's go Asian League, let's go an Invitational, let's go have a drive. Circuit, I only know this circuit, Okayama, I think I might be mispronouncing that one, but I only know that track from iRacing. It's the only time I've ever seen this track before. This is the bike I've been using the most at the moment, the Yamaha. I think it was the bike I started with, or a bike I don't really know. Whatever it is, it's the one I've been using. And we're going to go and find out how terribly badly, because I've not tried this circuit on this game before. I think this was on a previous Ride game. I very vaguely remember it from that as well. Weather, yes, we have that. I don't know if you can have variable weather in a race, but you certainly can have rain. You can have a wet race. I mean, this is like a damp circuit, but you can have it pouring down with rain. Let's go and start. Now, I shall be honest here. As I said, I don't really know what I'm doing with bikes. I'm not very good with bikes. So I do still have... I'm on relatively easy difficulty with the AI, mostly because I fall off a fair bit at the moment. I'm starting to get there, but it's going to take me a while. I do also have some assists turned on. I have minimal amounts of traction control and ABS, but it's the anti-wheeling that's the problem. I can't stop this damn bike from wheeling. I mean, this is a quick bike. Oh, hello. We got a little bit booped by everybody there. Okay, well, this is probably not going to work for a first race. I have an anti-wheelie assist turned on. We cannot figure out how to stop this damn thing from wheeling and still making any sort of lap speed. Now, I have no doubt that is something that I will learn in time, but for me not getting too annoyed with this bloody game, I've just left it on a little bit. And now you can turn off the assists are very Gran Turismo-esque. I can't actually do it on this track because it's constant cornering. But if we use the D-pad, we can actually cycle through. So you see we have tyre wear currently going on. Yes, that's a thing to worry about. But we can cycle through there, can have anti-wheelie and all of that sort of stuff. On and off. Very difficult to kind of show it on this track because it's a pretty busy track. But yes, we can turn that off actually in the middle of the race if you fancy a challenge and stick it back on when things go horrifically wrong. As I said, the AI's on relatively easy as well, because I don't really know what the hell I'm doing. We don't really have a huge amount of time in this one. I've been doing much longer races. Probably won't have time to recover from... Oh, God. From this, necessarily. We're going to run in a bit too deep through there. Oh, we're going to move around a lot on the exit of that corner. I'm actually really struggling with this circuit. We have not got the speed, it would seem, around here. Well, so much for a nice straightforward start. I will get back past you. No, don't bounce across the grass. Jeez. So, in terms of driving physics, look, I don't know a damn thing about bikes, as I keep saying. It's certainly a fun physics engine to try and learn, to try and deal with here. Bikes are very, well, funnily enough, very different to cars. You drive them, you race them very differently, and I'm not quite used to it, but this is the sort of game that makes me want to get better. And I am gradually getting there. This track here is very fiddly compared to the ones I have been driving. Not quite got the hang of it. It's almost like you... Oh, don't do that. Oh! That's a death and a half right there. That was one hell of a death off towards the wall. This race has very much not gone my way. Christ, this is a really twisty circuit. This is a really, really twisty circuit for a bike, and now we've gone over. So, again, bear in mind, I do have some traction control on for this. Yes, it's still going to snap. It's still going to bite. Going to move around a lot there. You can actually see the way the traction control is fighting. It's a rewarding physics engine, in as far as if you get things right, well, you get some really cool lap times. It's great to drive. It's difficult for me to get the hang of it. But yeah, I would say it is a good handling model. It's a fun handling model to try and wrap your head around in terms of racing the bikes. And you know, you've got all sorts of different classes of bikes. You've got full-on race bikes that can drive very differently to your more road-going bikes. I don't know too much about the classes of them. All I know is here I was absolutely thrashed by everything. That is not a great... Yeah, no, we get a point. That's not really what we want. That didn't really go so well, if I'm honest with you. We can kind of ignore that. I'm not sure whether we're going to fare so well on those circuits. I haven't actually done the American League, any of the American stuff over here. Where can we go with the American circuits? Oh, I don't know any of these tracks. Shall we go Laguna? I feel like Laguna might be about the only place I stand even a smidge of a chance by virtue of I actually know Laguna Seca from other games fairly well. That being said, I'm probably going to die. Before we go jumping, let's go have a look at some customization. So you can change liveries on the bikes, and I think you unlock these various bits and pieces along the way. Now, there is a customization for the bike. Now, you can customize the engine. Ooh, we could go for even faster if we want more death on our bike. I don't think that was unlocked when I... Oh, Jesus, it's expensive, though. Sure, why not? So much like when it comes to Forza, for example, or any of those kind of car games, if you will, you have your customization. You can customize your exhaust, you can customize your engine. Downside is it feels a little bit limited. Okay, yes, we can get some bigger brakes on the bike, which I think is probably a good idea, knowing my struggles here. Let's go for some big old brakes. We can get some racing suspension, I think. It doesn't seem to change much. Maybe it makes it adjustable or something. But it's not crazy in depth. Admittedly, I don't know much about, you know, modifying bikes in general, and there probably isn't as much you can do with bikes as it is as you can with cars. Oh, wait, we can have racing mirrors. Oh, wait, no, wait. Racing mirrors just means you take them off. I feel like mirrors are kind of helpful for racing anyway, know where stuff is. We can remove that stuff at the back as well if we want. Yes, let's go for that, make it more racy. Like engine, you don't have individual bits of the engine you can upgrade. It's just we can have it either 131 horsepower or 150 horsepower, and that's kind of it. So I might perhaps want a little bit more depth on this. The tire thing is interesting to an extent. You have road tires and you have race tires. If you put the bike on to race tires, you can then choose the compound of tire for the events, which will come in to play in the longer stuff, basically. So there is some customization. I was hoping for perhaps a little bit more in terms of that. We've now got a faster Yamaha to go and tackle this next race once we get loaded in. Visually wise, the game looks pretty good, I have to say. If you want to drive from first person camera, you can. I struggle enough as it is with the view and all the assists and stuff, you know, at the moment, so I'm not going to go and try more ridiculous stuff. Here we go, select tyres. So yeah, now that I put racing tyres on it, I can choose to go for different compound tyres. And you can actually have different compound tyres front and rear. So for example, if you're burning up the rear tyres, you go for a medium at the back and soft at the front. I don't know how I'm not good enough at this game to be able to tell you differences in terms of handling, because I'll probably be struggling just keeping the bike on the track, but it is an option. You know, if you want to mix and match, it will probably come in handy. Here we're only doing a 3-lap race. There's no reason to change the stuff that we have, basically. I don't know if we're going to be able to do much around here. Please bite yourself down much. Well, we've got 10 horsepower. Although on a bike, that's quite a lot. You know, we've got another good chunk of power going on. We've got big brakes, hopefully. That was a terrible start from me. Now, can we do better on this run down towards the first corner? I'm hoping so. We're going to get a little bop from behind. Thank you for that one. Christ, we're going outside of everybody. We're going to climb over someone. Now, for some reason, my bikes always seem to be a mile quicker than everything else in a straight line. Now, okay, sure, this thing here is upgraded. Well, the AI bikes do have different ratings, and there are different bikes and different ratings, but even in a couple of the career mode stuff where I've been given bikes, I seem to massively outrun everything in a straight line. Now, I can't figure out if that's the game's way of trying to do difficulty, like on the lower difficulties it just slows the AIs down in a straight line, or whether there's something I'm doing with the bikes, something I'm doing with the riding. I can't imagine that's all just different corner styles. I don't know. I do think I'm probably driving these bikes very much like a car, and I'm not sure that's right. I think there's a lot more different things we could be doing in terms of like racing lines and stuff. Overtaking is always sketchy. I say sketchy, it's just different with the bikes. You can make passes work in different ways. And I would give you a demonstration, only I have no idea. And most of the time I'm just out-dragging stuff down the longer straight. But yeah, you can make passes stick on the outside in different ways than you would with a car, which is fun. Again, I like the challenge of racing something different. Oh, I might not make this final corner. There we go, we just about survived that. Also, you've got your brakes are separate, so you have a rear brake and a front brake. The front brake is the important one on the most part, so your front brake is on the left trigger. The A button is for the rear brake. Ooh, come on, slow down for turn one. It's something to get your head around that. That's not too bad, I've just about got the hang of that. I'm not going to say that. I've got used to pressing the buttons. Whether I'm using it correctly or not, I don't know. Basically, if the back end starts giving you trouble under braking, just release the rear brake. You don't want the back end moving around too much under braking. It's how you'll go wobble and fall off. I'm stabbing at the throttle. I'm not quite so good at the smooth application of the throttle at the moment. Right, can I go around? I was thinking about trying to go around the outside. Not going to work. Instead, what I'll go for is get a good exit, which we do. We will out-drag you up the hill. That'll be a position for me. Can we slow down though for this corner? Yes, indeed we can. Right, it's fine. All is good. All is good. Got another lap to go to try and hold on. Oh, that's a lot of moving around under braking. Oh, down the corkscrew. Get that one right. Tire consumption. As I said, tire consumption is a thing I'm pretty sure that's new for ride 4. Now, in these races, the tires seem to wear very quickly, and then when they get to their sort of like the last 20%, it seems to wear a lot slower. I haven't actually killed a set of tyres yet, although admittedly, I have only been doing early stuff. Oh, no, I don't want to do that, do we now? That's terrible. That's very right. There is a rewind button, if you wish. I'm trying to do better at not using it unless it's A, AI doing something dumb, or B, you know, it's the end of a long race and I really don't want to have to go do it again. The AIs, in terms of racing against them, you can have some fun battles. Oh, God. Hello. They will make mistakes, as you see there. There's a big dive from them trying to take the lead away, and the front end fell over on them. They can be good to race against. Oh, no. You know what? I can't be bothered to do this race again. We just got it wrong on the throttle. It's really easy. Yeah, they can be good fun to race against. They can sometimes be a little bit oblivious to the player. There have been times when I've been minding my business around a corner and AI just comes sort of steaming in and wipes you out. Turn one at the Nürburgring GP circuit, for example, I've been taking a line through there and had an AI dive bomb, although admittedly players do that stuff quite easily as well. You know, it's easy to make a mistake under braking into turn one at the Nürburgring GP circuit. But yeah, on the most part, they're not too bad to race with. They can be a little oblivious. And there are different settings for the physics on this. I run it with like simulation physics, if you will. There are easier settings if you don't want it to be quite as ridiculously difficult getting the hang of the bikes, which I mean it's good for, you know, accessibility. Everyone wants to jump into crazy difficult bikes, especially if you don't really know a thing about bikes or bike racing. I choose to drive with the real physics or whatever it's called on here because I have more fun with that sort of stuff, even if I don't really know what I'm doing half the time. Oh God. But this does make for I mean, falling off is very easy on here, as you've already seen, you know, bubble cars. To be fair, it probably is with real bikes. You know, I can't criticise that as such. It's just a general warning. It is easy to make little mistakes and to end up flipping off of your bike or falling off of your bike when you're running on the more realistic of the physics models. So, well, there we go. That was one of the invitational events. We'll score some points and then that will give us some money. The money's okay. Bikes, some of them are quite expensive on here. There is a lot of gift. There are a lot of prize bikes. So if you work your way through the career cleverly, you probably won't have to buy very many bikes necessarily, because you can keep winning prize bikes to use in other events and so on and so forth. Yeah, bikes are quite expensive on here, to say the least. For example, if we wanted to, what was I looking at doing? I haven't got a bike for this, do I? Oh, I have one bike because I won a prize bike. So I can use this for this event, but it is very, very low on the rating. It's probably the slowest bike that we can. If we go to the dealership, we're going to look at all of the bikes. Yeah, it's sort of like 150,000 for some of these. 400,000 if you want what's technically the fastest of them. Now, that's quite a chunk of money. It looks cool, I have to say. It does look brutal, I will give it that. I kind of quite like that bike, that's cool. But yeah, the Triumph, for example, that we won. There are plenty of prize bikes, though, to be had around the place. And, of course, stuff can be upgraded to be competitive in these events. So, yeah, I mean, the economy's not too terrible on this. Oh, it was one of these that I was looking at getting a bike for, I think it was. Yeah, there's a decent selection of bikes. You'll probably find something that you like. Yes, a lot of money for something that I presume is very, very quick. So, yeah. As far as game modes go, I mean, as I said, there's a lot to be doing in the single player. There's a lot of events, a lot of championships to be working your way through, and they do have their own, I say, variety of bits and pieces that go on in them, in terms of it's not just straight-up racing. However, there is a couple of things that are really, really, really annoying. I'm going to use this event here because it's pissed me off no end. There's a couple, though. Basically, the time attack stuff is horrible on this game for a couple of reasons. So the time attack is you have a lap to go and beat a certain lap time. Fair enough. Not exactly anything new or anything particularly extreme. However, the way the game does off-track penalties is absurd. It really is very stupid. So you go off the track and your lap time's going to be invalidated. Okay, fair enough. The thing is, not only if you go off the track is your lap time invalidated, you have to breathe off the circuit. So there, for example, that is enough to invalidate the lap time, despite the fact, I mean, I barely put the wheels off the off the circuit. Now, that's absurd on that, especially considering I haven't even started the lap at that point. I've not even affected the final corner at that point. It is doing that sort of thing. Now, whether I'm going to be able to show you all around this circuit or not, I don't know, but there are some places, some circuits where I've been doing these time trials, and if you put a wheel on the curb, it has invalidated it. We're talking just ran onto the curb, which is, I mean, I generally associate the curb as being, you know, a bit of a track that you're allowed to be using here. Oh, so is it going to do it here? I'm kind of curious as to how far can I stretch it. No, I didn't really get that corner wide enough to really find that out. But yeah, we'll probably end up ballsing up around here somewhere just by making silly little mistakes. But it is insanely overzealous with the track limits. Now, in an actual race, I say it's insanely overzealous with the track limits. It is with time trial. Now, in a race, there can be penalties. Are we going to... No, so this one here lets me go on the curb there. Oh, I know the corner's going to be really pain in the ass. I'm not worried about the lap time here. This is more for demonstrative purposes. The exit of this corner here is really horrible. Oh, I actually overran it a little bit. I'll go about it. Do it. But yeah, like over here, for example, all you have to do is go a tiny, tiny little bit wider to get pissy. Anyway, as I said before, I got distracted. The track extending penalties or corner cutting penalties, it will give you a time penalty if you run off in the middle of a race. Okay, that's fair enough, really. However, they're weird and random almost, to the point where, what do we want to do? Let's go to, I don't know this track very well, but let's go have a try around here. But yeah, there are times where, again, much as you saw me run wide there and it stopped it, they'll give you a time penalty. Now, these do vary based on the size of the discrepancy. So if you run a tiny, tiny smidge wide, you might only get a tenth of a second, half a tenth of a second even penalty, which is okay. if you cut a corner, you can get 3-4 second penalties. It's not too bad, although it seems to be random on what some circuits. I think it's the Algarve circuit. I drove around and I spent a lap with, I'll be honest, not a lot of my bike on the circuit. I'd never driven the track before, to be fair to me. I didn't really know where I was going, much as this one here I don't really know either. But yeah, I've never driven the track before. I spent half my time off the circuit. Game didn't really care. Other times it is just a case of you go a little bit wide and oh, there's a penalty. It's a little inconsistent and often quite overzealous. Yes, something needs to be done, of course, to try and prevent some form of corner cutting, try and get some sort of fairness and all that, which I understand. And on the most part, it's not too bad in terms of the time penalty for the races. Okay, it can be a little bit silly at times, but at least that's fair. The time attack stuff is quite ridiculous, really. It's just unnecessarily mean. It takes quite a long time to then go and restart the race for when it has failed. Oh, where am I going? Track list is pretty good, as you can already tell. There's a bunch of real-world circuits. There's a couple of fictional locations, but on the most part, it's real-world circuits. You've got things like the Nürburgring, the GP, you've got the full Nordschleife. You've got plenty of British circuits, which is always fun to see, like Donington Park and Alton Park and all of those sort of ones. And you've got some fun, American circuits. I haven't seen this track very often. Was it the Canadian? I can never remember the name of the damn thing. This one. Some of you will know. You don't see this all that often. There's Phillip Island as well in here, which is cool. Oh, Tsukuba on bikes is entertaining. That's, I'm so used to Tsukuba in cars that when I drive it with a bike, I get very confused. Sugo, I think, is in here as well, which is, again, I really like that circuit. Really good circuit. Certainly in cars. Not actually driven it with the bikes yet. Oh, this is kind of fun. This is a strange circuit. It's very wide. It feels very wide. Anyway, we're going to go very wide through there. So are you giving me a penalty? See, sometimes that like corner extending, track extending like that will net you a penalty. Sometimes the game just doesn't care all too much. Oh, don't move around too much in the rain, please. That's fine. See? What's that? I get a penalty. Admittedly, it's a tiny penalty, so I'm not that fussed, but I ran out onto the curb that seemed perfectly fair, yet when I went completely wide of a corner, nothing. I don't know. Luckily, we are quite well clear of everything. Oh, don't mind the elevation changes. Don't bump over the curbs too hard. That's when you're going to crash your bloody bike. We will run down this back straight. And then, as I said, there are other events outside of just these sort of straight-up races. You've seen some of the time attacks. There's the overtaking challenges. The goal, you've got to overtake a certain number of bikes around the place. I think there was one that was like you have to drive through, it's like a time trial, or like time trial on a section of a track, you have to drive through like gates. There's plenty of stuff to be doing, plenty of variety. And certainly if you like bikes, there is a lot going on with this game. Oh, come on. Yeah, I'm on. Around the final quarter we go. I'm eager to get on the throttle, just don't want to slide around. We're a decent lead, but it's not necessarily the biggest. Not a sort of lead that we have comfortable room to make an error on. No, I'm going to go wide again on the exit of that one. Yeah, game just doesn't care about the exit of turn one. We can do as wide as we like there, but just don't brush the curb on the exit of one of these corners, I think. Was it here? Oh, sliding the bikes around. That's terrifying. Even as I said, traction control on, well, I have the minimum amount on basically. It's just enough to make it a little easier for me. I can still get into a massive amount of trouble with this one. I'll have a lift down there. I can see the whole thing's shaking around almost as I'm trying to get this right. Oh, that's a horrible corner. And now we just have a fairly quick section for the end of it. I mean, as far as the game goes, I have to say I've been very much enjoying my time. It's easy to just, sit down and, well, what was supposed to be, a short little session, you know, spending a couple of hours just messing around with bikes, trying to get better with this one. Yes, I don't really know what I'm doing, and I know I'm doing lots of things wrong in terms of racing lines. I'm starting slowly to get the hang of racing these bikes. It is very, very good fun. There's a good selection of tracks, a decent selection of all sorts of bikes. Going on, so not that I know a huge amount about them, but there seems to be a good amount to choose from. There are some niggles, most definitely. The overzealous track limits is one of the more annoying. The occasional incompetent AI can be a pain in the ass. A lot of it, there's a lot of inexperience from me as well. I'm playing, so I'm playing on a relatively low difficulty. There is, I mean, I'm about 40 out of 100, so you can really whack the difficulty up if you know what you're doing when it comes to the comes to the racing. So yeah, I mean, I've been very much enjoying my time with this game. At the end of the day, I, who knows nothing about bikes, has had a lot of fun playing around with the bikes on here. There's an awful lot to be doing with this game, so yeah, would definitely get a recommendation from me. Probably going to go and fall off bikes some more. Oh, there's also customization, of course, how could I forget? Customization of your rider as well, if you want to go and, you know, do all of that. You can mess around with all of that stuff as well, which is fun. It's just, yeah, it's just a good, entertaining bike racing game, pretty much. Well, that is going to be it from me. Thank you all very much for watching, and until next time, a goodbye.